Valley Old Middle School building. Oh, and over the summer, I got contacts. Not only did I not get called a nerd today, but my tall, neat, Becky the Shrimp, tall. I was amazed last May. My petite pants started to look a little short, but I was absolutely flabbergasted when I grew 8 inches over the summer and no longer looked like a wobbly bully. I mean, can you believe it? So much has changed. Brad actually came up to me today and was like, "I didn't even know the guy knew my name." Which brings me to another subject. Boys! I was stunned when Derek Fisher, the gorgeous captain of the football team, came up to me today. "Hi, Becky. You look really hot today. Want to go to homecoming?" I can't believe it. My first official date. Sure, I know that Derek has a reputation, and he'll probably want more from me than just a slow dance at homecoming, but let's face it, I need a boyfriend. All I've ever wanted is for someone to love me. I can't let this opportunity pass me by. I've got to be relentless for him. Dear Diary, it's sophomore year now, and I'm so glad for our fresh start. As you guessed, things with Derek didn't turn out too well. We went to homecoming, and it was fun. But the real trouble started after homecoming, when he officially asked me to be his boyfriend. Things were great for a while, but then he started pressuring me to sleep with him. And even though I didn't want to, I gave in, just to keep him from leaving. After we started sleeping together, our relationship grew really tense, and after a huge fight, he broke up with me. Well, I can tell you right now, I am so done with boys. I decided to focus on becoming one of the popular kids. I even tried out for the cheerleading squad today. Hopefully I can keep relentlessly pursuing this goal without things going south, like they did with Derek. Dear Diary, it's junior year, and I'm so happy to be an upperclassman. Last year, I made the cheerleading squad, and guys were the popular child, but this year I try out. W-I-N, let's win! I broke 2 bones in my leg and won't be able to cheer anymore. Since my GPA has gotten really low due to my social life and my friends seem to want nothing to do with me, I decided to focus this year on getting my academics back on track. I mean, what could be better than being relentless after my schoolwork? Wish me luck. Dear Diary, it's senior year now, and I have the most amazing news. I met the love of my life tonight. You see, I was at youth group with my friend Jen, and a youth pastor started speaking about this man named Jesus. Apparently, he loved me so much that he died just to take the punishment for the wrong things I've done. And he'll never leave me or let me down. As the youth pastor was speaking, I realized that I've been relentless after all the wrong things during my high school years. Freshman year, I gave my heart away to an undeserving boy. Sophomore year, I went all out to gain popularity. And junior year, I drove myself and everyone around me ragged trying to achieve academic success. But I've never really been happy until tonight. Because tonight, I let go. When her youth pastor asked who would like to give their life to Christ and surrender fully to Him, I stood up and shouted, "I will! I will go! I will reach out to others! I will abandon my whole heart to Christ and give every part of me to Him! I will be relentless after the one!" Then I looked around and asked, "Will you?"